Hello and welcome to the Money Marketing Podcast. I'm Kimberly Dondo, Digital Content Manager, and this week we have reporter Momodou Touré asking whether the advice sector should do more to tackle poor advice. Take it away, Momodou.
A lot of advices do not cut the mustard. This statement might take you aback. You might even say, how dare you? Or what do you know anyway? Let me make a full disclosure. This blunt statement was made recently by an advisor with more than 3 decades of experience. Investment Quorum's chief executive, Petronella West, caused a bit of a stir with her forthright assessments of the state of the advice sector. It raised lots of eyebrows and generated spicy headlines for the trade press. The industry veteran told a Lancet webinar last Wednesday that the advice sector is in a mess because of a lack of quality advisors, and that deadwood in the supply chain is weighing down the price of advice. She highlighted the British steel debacle as an example of the untold damage a few bad actors can do to the advice sector. How is it possible in today's age that mess is allowed and continues to fester? That affects us all, from the financial service compensation scheme levies we all got this year. I am paying double, £50,000 compared to £25,000 last year. I'm bailing out the crap. You can blame the regulator, but quite frankly, it is not there to be the gatekeeper of doing the right thing. It is there to stop things when it finds them out, but by then it's too late, Petronella West told her audience. We have the regulator the industry deserves. It's not the one I think my firm deserves. There are some very good firms out there, but the financial planning industry is still flawed, she added. End of quote. Her forthright statements on the advice sector seem to have taken many, including advisors, by surprise. When Money Marketing reported this story last week, some angry advisors made their views known on the below-the-line comments of the article. One wrote, utter nonsense. The FCA should be preventing disasters by regulating and weeding out the wrongdoers, leaving the good firms to get on with doing a good job for their client. Another said, isn't it one of any regulator's fundamental purposes to be the gatekeeper of doing the right thing and to do as much as is reasonably possible to head off looming disasters before they become full-blown train wrecks? It could, and indeed should, be done by a competent and properly focused regulator, but seems to be quite beyond the abilities of the FCA. One added, it's not me, it's everyone else. The view from the rose-tinted specs must be quite spectacular from Petronella's ivory tower. Arrogance at times can be a good quality. Not sure who said it, and there lies the answer. End of quote. These reactions from the sector were expected. A great number of advisors continue to bury their heads in the sand when it comes to the bad apples in their ranks. Just reading some of the advisors' comment above, you would think Petronella's statement was about the FCA instead of bad advice. This bubble or silo mentality will do a lot of harm to the sector if not adequately addressed. It is a known fact that there are bad actors in the sector who are messing it for the many who play by the rules and offer quality advice to their clients. No need to repeat the cliche of one bad apple, but the barrel will continue to bear the brunt if the bad apples are not weeded out. As Petronella aptly pointed out, bad advice is costly for everyone involved, clients, advisors, and the regulators. We have had the defined benefit pension transfer debacle, the London Capital and Finance mini-bond mis-selling, the closet index fund scandal, Standard Life annuities mis-selling, just to name a few of the high-profile cases where bad advice has left thousands of consumers and investors out of pocket. The advice sector needs to get its act together to root out the bad actors giving unsuitable advice. Just blaming the regulators, which many are fond of doing, won't address the problem. Some root and branch reforms are needed to shake up the sector. The ongoing tiff between the Personal Finance Society and the Chartered Insurance Institute should be settled rather quickly and amicably. It's a distraction the advice sector can do without. A professional code of ethics is another tool worth considering in a bid to get advisors to act honorably and stop the claims culture. The FCA, despite its many shortcomings, had made gains in improving standards across the financial marketplace. Its retail distribution review, financial advice, market review, and consumer duty, among other regulatory tools, have all made the sector work better for consumers and minimize harm. The FCA, despite many shortcomings, had made gains in improving standards across the financial marketplace. The FCA, despite many shortcomings, has made gains in improving standards across the financial marketplace. Its retail distribution review, financial advice, market review, the consumer duty, among other regulatory tools, have all made the sector work better for consumers and minimize harm. Despite the progress made so far, there is still a long way to go in addressing the issue of bad advice. The professional indemnity premiums and the FSCS levy continue to rise year on year. Despite the progress made so far, there is still a long way to go in addressing the issue of bad advice. The professional indemnity premiums and the FSCS levy continue to rise year on year. According to the FCA, the FSCS levies have risen considerably, driven by pension and investment compensation claims over the past 10 years. And the claims in this class have risen from £130 million in 2012 to an eye-watering £453 million in 2021. This should be a wake-up call for advisors to remedy the situation. To use a football metaphor here, you don't blame the referee if your team concedes a penalty because of the reckless tackle of one of your players. The FCA has reiterated its commitment to tackling poor advice and recently unveiled plans to target a 10% annual drop on FSCS levies from 2025. The FCA said, "We want to strengthen firms' resilience where they make mistakes, but we also need to continue to clamp down on bad actors and for industry to work with us to strengthen standards and address poor practice in all its forms." Notwithstanding her straightforward assessment of the advice sector, Petronella West still believes things will improve for the sector and the good advice firms will continue to put the customers first. She said, "We need more advisors with that right philosophy and culture in them. The new ones coming through show there is a real good future, but we need to work a little bit harder at it. It seems we need the good in the profession to pull together." Thank you.
Thank you, Momadou, for yet another wonderful weekend essay. We do hope that you enjoyed it. Please do keep up to date with all our new releases via Podbean, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and everywhere else you get your podcasts from. You can also keep up to date with all our new content published on the Money Marketing website, as well as Twitter and LinkedIn. See you next time.